How many albums would you say have no skips? Start to finish, you are playing through the whole thing and enjoying it. I can think of a few, namely Fruit from Marina and the Diamonds and Electra Heart from Marina and the Diamonds. Yes, this is the 10th anniversary still in its wrapping. Thank you for noticing. This would be the part where I'd mention the obvious no-skip album, Beyoncé's Renaissance, and then I'd bring out the vinyl, if I only had one. But those albums are all from seasoned musicians or artists with a lot of name recognition. Marina has sort of fallen off since then, but do not question my metaphor here. It's a rare feat for a solo artist to do that with a debut album, as the ludicrously talented Amber Mark has done for the record Three Dimensions Deep. As this video title suggests, and I really hope that this message gets out to Amber, this 17-track album, her first full length, has no skips. I think that this is because, in part, Amber Mark is just not new to music. She released her only other real collection of music, the mini album 333 AM, all the way back in 2017, and I've yet to listen to it, but it is on the docket, I swear. I believe she released a few singles and a short EP bridging the gap from then to now, but I think this span of time, considered with the fantastic quality of Three Dimensions Deep, leads me to believe that there was a ton of thought put into this album. This album is a pop and R&B fusion, and pop and R&B, especially nowadays, are not strangers towards each other. Even some of the biggest names in the music industry, Ariana Grande for example, have shown some heavy influence from the R&B sound. However, the vibrance and the complexity that both styles can exhibit on their own has definitely proven difficult for some artists. When they're fused together, if an artist misses bullseye, to me it feels like they've shot so far off the target they've missed it entirely. I am happy to say Amber has hit the mark dead center here. I think that there's no better place to start with discussing this album than with the album's first track, One. Not to bring up musical theater now, in two of these back to back, but One does exactly what a good Broadway opening number should do. One here introduces the major sounds of this album, the heavy bass but still upbeat rhythm that is exemplary of pop R&B fusion. However, further than that, as all great opening numbers do, One introduces a lot of the major themes of this record. There is a bug. Gross. Okay, where was I? Major themes of this album. The cliff notes would be talking about self-worth and change, and about a higher, almost cosmic power that frequently in this album takes the form of Amber's mother, who has since passed. It's very clear that her mom has had a profound impact on the woman that Amber Mark is today. The track that follows, What It Is, pretty much takes what One sets up and then cranks it up to the max. It is an absolutely beautiful piece, and it's no wonder that it was one of the lead singles for Three Dimensions Deep. Not only does Amber share a wonderfully humble and tender contemplation on the meaning of life, with lyrics such as, "Don't know how, a feeling so strange, the way that time never stays the same, so is life with failure and age, wondering why we throw so much shame," but she also sets that to some beautiful music. The bridge is brilliant, and then there's this blues rock guitar interlude that comes right before the final chorus that is fantastic. My first time listening to this, I was genuinely gagged. Then on to track 3, Most Men. Don't worry, I'm not going through Three Dimensions Deep track by track, but it just happens to have a fantastic beginning. Now, Most Men's pick up from its gospel sound at the beginning into its main clasping beat is an interesting dichotomy, sure, but honestly, what I really liked about this song was its message. Perhaps my favorite lyrics in all of Three Dimensions Deep, "It is very rare, but baby, it does exist. And when you find it, love, you'll realize it comes from within." And it's complete with some wonderful harmonies under it, like, oh my god. I have been on my I don't need a man recently, and so this song just came at the perfect time. I'm happy that the main focus of this song ultimately was constructive, to lift the audience up, but at the end of the day, most men are garbage, don't understand what love is. Speaking of songs that really spoke to me, FOMO, my favorite off this entire album. It's definitely a more danceable track on this album, and y'all know I love some dance music, so immediately FOMO stood out for that, but it's unexpectedly anthemic, if I'm being honest. Inspiration in modern music isn't like new or anything, but this isn't Christina Aguilera's Beautiful, okay? I feel like I relate at a very deep level with FOMO's story, and to such an extent here, that is rare. It speaks about holding back, about decidedly keeping yourself away from socializing, and yet, consequently feeling left out. Hoo boy, I felt that very hard! Also, Amber shows off her rapping skills on this song more than any other track on this album, I'd say, and, like, cue the Demi Lovato Camp Rock clip. She's really good. I especially liked the bars, see my friends and their stories, can't keep living on through their stories. That was very good, poignant. Okay, I have been gushing about these tracks in depth for a little bit too long now, so I'm just gonna speed run through the rest of this album. Dark Side. It's got this awesome different sound compared to the rest of this album that I really enjoyed. Am I crazy in saying this, or it's sort of giving me a subtle hint of early Santa Gold vibes? Please don't hate me for saying that. Then there's the song Bubbles. I don't really get the metaphor that Amber is going on about, even when she explained it on Apple Music, which I think is a rare lyrical falter on this album, but nevertheless, it's a great song. It's got this interesting Afrobeat to it, almost a tropical sound, and it's very catchy. On and On. Now, this was one of the tracks that I thought was more forgettable my first time going through this album, but the more I've listened to this album, the more it grew on me. Amber Mark's passive, almost detached singing combined with the plodding melody of this song gives me vibes of Super Rich Kids, and trust me when I say any comparison to Frank Ocean is a compliment of the highest order. It's also another one of the songs that I relate to. Foreign Things. Hands down one of the most approachable songs to this album, and it was actually how I discovered this album. It's really good, super fun, one of the strongest here on Three Dimensions Deep, and it's guaranteed by the song's end to make you feel luxe and lavish. I think that that line, smoke from my lips looked like exhaust, is tremendous imagery, and not to mention that this also has a tremendous music video, which she helped direct. I know that's right. Lastly, there's the song Out of This World, which a lot of people were saying was this album's mediocre part, but honestly, I kind of liked it. It's incredibly spatial, and it's complemented with these big, booming bass noises to it. I highly recommend listening to the song with headphones on, and maybe on some legal edibles. The ending is especially noteworthy because it's a fantastic showcase of Amber's stunning singing voice, along with these patient, interesting synth sounds. To a lot of people, this song was the album's lowest point, but I'm gonna be honest, I really think it's one of the highest. But unfortunately, there are some low points here. Even Renaissance had All Up in Your Mind. Like, I'm not gonna skip it, but did it really need to be there? Turning Pages, unfortunately, and I really don't like using this word, sounds generic, and its lyrics about Amber Mark's insecurities provide nothing new that other songs on this album haven't already done, and with better music to boot. Also, the song Cosmic is not really one of my favorites either, which wouldn't be that big of a problem, but it happens to be the longest track on this album, and when taking that into account, it certainly overstays its welcome just a bit. I do like its intro, though. It makes me feel like I'm waking up on an alien planet in this beautiful rainstorm. That is cool. And then we get to the closer. Well, closers of this album. Let me start with the actual final track of Three Dimensions Deep, the song Event Horizon. I really wish Amber cut this song. I get that this is sort of like Three Dimensions Deep's end credit song. I get that it's a send-off to all this celestial theming we've been exploring through this record, and I get that it's basically a final exhale of the song that came before it, Bliss. I do get all that, but nevertheless, I am unsatisfied with its inclusion in this record. To put a positive spin on it, it kind of feels like Amber put it at the end of the album for her. It needed to be in there for her rather than for us. However, I want to end this discussion talking on a high note, and that high note comes right before it, what feels like the actual final closer of this album, this song, Bliss. Y'all, this song is... it is amazing. The music here perfectly walks that line between sexuality and happiness. I mean, just listen to that funky bass. Bliss really isn't about sex, though, at least I don't really think so. It's more so about the stage that comes after happiness. Self-actualization that just has come out of the blue. Honestly, Bliss feels like the final evolution of my favorite lyrics on this album, the ones I mentioned from the song Most Men. Bliss is the rare kind of love that you find within yourself. Also, Bliss's chorus is perfectly catchy and inviting. It makes me feel like I want to sing along with Amber and join in on the glee. Truly, I have been going through this exact feeling myself. Starting to create videos like this, even working on my own art outside of this, it's all rooted from this inexplicable feeling of capability that I've suddenly found. Even when I do get low, it feels like it's painted in this different color from all this dread I've been bearing through within the last few years. I'm extremely particular about how you close an album, so don't take it lightly when I say this. Bliss is one of the strongest closers I have heard in a very, very, very long time. So, yeah. Leave a like if you haven't already. This was my second time recording this all the way through because I found out at the very end of the first recording session my microphone wasn't plugged in. Either way, I'm very proud of myself that I was able to make a second one of these. Maybe I'll even do a third. I do have an album in mind. In the meantime, leave a comment telling me what you thought about this album. Follow my socials and have a good day.